Today we go over the Star Wars franchise when it comes to writer and director Rian Johnson of Star Wars The Last Jedi and the character of Supreme Leader Snoke. This is Mike Zero here. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, as you all know, in The Last Jedi, we had that big, surprising, and shocking moment that was quite unexpected. I would say in the middle of the movie, in which Kylo Ren slices Supreme Leader Snoke in two by use of Anakin's lightsaber. So, looking at all of this, a lot of people have been wondering as to exactly why Rian Johnson killed off Supreme Leader Snoke without any backstory. This is the one thing that fans really wanted to learn more about, Snoke's backstory. Now, though Rian Johnson, you know, he wasn't the one who created the character originally, it was all JJ, and Rian picked it up from The Force Awakens, because like always, when you're creating a trilogy with different directors like this, everybody is, of course, in discussions with each other, discussing their different ideas of characters, places, etc. And this is actually the big reason as to why BB-8 didn't end up traveling to Ahch-To as originally intended, and ended up being R2-D2. This was all communication between both directors JJ and Rian. But looking past all of this, I wanted to go over what Rian Johnson had to say about Snoke's backstory and why he specifically did not edit in. So this is what Rian had to say. You have to remember that I wrote the movie before The Force Awakens came out, so I didn't write it in the context of, oh, all these people on Reddit are writing their theories on how he's Darth Plagueis or whatever. It's not like I read all those theories and decided to defy them. He goes on to state, to me, first of all, it just wasn't a question that I felt very interested in, mostly because I didn't feel like the character of Rey would be interested in it. It's not Snoke's story, I guess. So in that way, he's very similar to the Emperor in the first trilogy, where we know exactly what we need to know about him. He's the powerful shadowy Emperor behind Vader in the first one, and now Kylo in this one. He goes on to conclude, so frankly, it never occurred to me to suddenly stop the whole movie to explain his origins, because it wasn't really germane to the story. So that's what Rian Johnson had to say about Snoke's backstory and why he didn't add it into The Last Jedi. Now, what I'm hoping to happen, at least at some point in the future of this franchise, is that maybe in a live-action TV series, or maybe even another, you know, possible movie, you know, down the road with Disney and Lucasfilm, we will learn a whole lot more about Snoke, just how we did in the prequel trilogy with Emperor Palpatine. So with that being all done and said, what's also interesting is you guys may recall not too long ago that Andy Serkis went over how they also left out his backstory, Lucasfilm, they also left out his backstory to keep open the possibility of doing more movies with Supreme Leader Snoke, very much like how they did with Emperor Palpatine in the prequel trilogy. So it seems as though that Disney and Lucasfilm are just trying to keep their options open, but I will say, I think all it would have honestly taken was a minute, maybe two tops, to really give us a deep backstory to Supreme Leader Snoke. Exactly how does Luke Skywalker know him? I think that's one of the biggest things in The Last Jedi, right? When we're in that flashback scene, and he tells Rey, Snoke had already turned his heart, right? How does he know Snoke? Did Luke communicate with Supreme Leader Snoke? Well, there are hints, though not in the movie. In the novelization, you do learn that both Snoke and Luke crossed paths, at least remotely, via the Force, when they were trying to seek out the truth of the Force. Luke Skywalker was on his journey, and Snoke was on his. But I feel like that we shouldn't have to learn all of these different things in either books or comics. I think that a lot of these things should be implemented in a movie, and just extend the movie by a little bit. That's all I would have loved to see for The Last Jedi. But anyways, guys, drop a comment below. Let me know what you think about all of this in the comments, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you also very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Night to moon, we hear them moans again, oh.